Good Shepherd. I'm Kristen, your Children's Ministry Director, and I'm back with another devotional for you guys. And today marks the first day of VBS registration, so I'm going to bring you a VBS-themed devotional today. So this actually comes to us from day one of VBS, and it is the story of Ananias helping Saul from Acts 9. Saul, who after this encounter becomes Paul, was traveling to Damascus to persecute the Christians. He was a Jew and a Pharisee, and he was very upset about this new religion, and he was out to put a stop to it, basically. And so on the road to Damascus, this is a pretty famous story, he is encountered by Jesus, who asks him why he's persecuting him. He's blinded, and his friends have to get him into town. And so I'm going to pick up in Acts 9, verse 13 through 19, which is with the Lord speaking to Ananias, who he has chosen to go to Saul. So he has told Ananias to go to Saul and place his hands on him to restore his sight. And so this is what Ananias has to say in verse 13. "Lord," Ananias answered, "I have heard many reports about this man and all the harm he has done to your holy people in Jerusalem. And he has come here with authority from the chief priests to arrest all who call on your name." But the Lord said to Ananias, "Go. This man is my chosen instrument to proclaim my name to the Gentiles and their kings and to the people of Israel. I will show him how much he must suffer for my name." Then Ananias went to the house and entered it. Placing his hands on Saul, he said, "Brother Saul, the Lord Jesus, who appeared to you on the road as you were coming here, has sent me so that you may see again and be filled with the Holy Spirit." Immediately, something like scales fell from Saul's eyes, and he could see again. He got up and was baptized, and after taking some food, he regained his strength. All right, so on day one of VBS, we are going to be learning that Jesus's power helps us do hard things, and I can only imagine what Ananias must have been thinking when the Lord tells him that he has to go to Saul. He had already presided over Stephen's stoning. He had done so many things that would have been really scary, and yet the Lord doesn't encourage him and say, "Hey, it's okay, you'll be fine." He just goes and simply tells him to go because he has plans for Paul. Saul, who will become Paul now. So I think this is an important lesson right now. I think doing hard things is often difficult for all of us, and those hard things take many different forms. So right now we're faced with this pandemic, and there's lots of things that have been difficult for us. Not seeing some extended family, close friends maybe. Not being able to worship together has been tough in one place. Obviously, we've been worshiping remotely, but it is still different than actually being together. And these things are hard, and we face many hard things. We face disease, things like cancer, our friends and loved ones pass away, sometimes tragically. There's been a lot of unrest in our country right now. There's a lot of things that are hard, and so this day of this first day of VBS, which is called Rocky Railway, Jesus's power pulls us through. Every day we learn a new Bible point, and the Bible point on day one is Jesus's power helps us do hard things. And then there's a Bible verse to go with it. So I just told you the story that goes with day one, but the Bible verse is Philippians 4:13, "For I can do everything through Christ who gives me strength." And I think that's really important to remember, that we are asked to do hard things. We will face hardships, And yet we must remember that we can do all things through Christ, because it's Christ who strengthens us and allows us to be able to do those things that are very difficult. So I hope that if you have kids, you'll sign them up online starting today, June 1st. And we've decided to reduce the cost. So it's down to $25 per child. And since it won't be the same experience, we're going to try and give a little bit of a break with the price. So hopefully that will help. And I hope that you will just join me in prayer for all the families and kids that will be attending virtually this year. So I'm just going to close in prayer. Dear Jesus, thank you for giving us the strength to do hard things. Lord, I pray that you would help us to remember that strength comes from you. We are not called to do these things on our own, but through your power. And so, Lord, I just pray that you would help us all to remember that Jesus's power pulls us through, and you help us to do hard things in difficult circumstances. And so, Lord, I just lift up our families and friends, our community, and Lord, VBS this year, even though it'll be online and not in person, Lord, I just pray that you would bless everyone who takes part, and that there will be many things for all of us to learn. Lord, in your precious name we pray. Amen.